Good morning to one and all. So in the previous session we have seen design of EOT and we have reached till design of wire. That means we have only completed the step number one. So we have to move on with the step number two and so on. So if you can see in the step number one, we have designed a wire rope wherein we found out the diameter of the wire. And then we check the stress concentration of the rope, and then we find out the number of month the rope will work. Now we will move on to our next step, that is step number two. Step number two, herein we have to design or we have to select the pulley. So write design of sheave and pulley. See, this step is directly available in PSG. So the name is taken from PSG design of sheave, SHEAVE, and pulley. This is a part of the pulley and the name is directly there in the PSG. Therefore, we are not changing the name and we are considering the name directly. Right. So, if you feel if there is any blur in the video, please let me know. Please turn to PSG 9.10 for selection of sheave and a pulley. And based on that, we'll find out the values of the sheave and the pulley. So, if you can see on the PSG page number 9.10, all the things of the pulley are given to you. Let me turn to PSG page number 9.10. Yeah. So if you can see on the screen, you have a sheave and the pulley. The diagram is basically the upper part of the pulley. It is just the upper part from where the rope will be in contact with the pulley. The central part and the lower part is not there. Okay, so this is the upper and the lower part of the pulley that is being shown. So that is known as the sheave grooves. See, the proportion of sheave grooves are written and the dimensions are in mm. So based on the wire rope diameter, you have to select the sheave. Now, if you can see the sheave, there are various diameter given to you. That is dimensions given to you, A, B, C, and all. See, I will zoom that for you. A, B, C is clearly visible. Then capital C, H, R1, R2, R3, R4. Then D1, L. Right? Everything is there. Small e. So based on the diameter of the rope which we have selected in the previous step, you have to select the various proportions for the sheave and the pulley, right? So no need of drawing the diagram, as already the diagram is in PSG. We'll take the reference of that and we'll start solving. No need of to draw any diagram. So if you remember, we have selected one diameter. We have selected one diameter for the rope. If you can go and check, it is 29 mm. So we have selected one diameter for the rope, that is 29 mm. Based on that, you have to see from wire rope drum 29 mm or above and select. So we'll be selecting sheave for diameter which is about 29, that is 34.5. So uske proportions humko select karne hai. So based on this, you have to select A, B, C, then E, H, L. E, H, and L from PSG 9.10. Right? So I will come back to the camera. So if you can see sir, what I have written, you please note that down.
Sir, kabhi rope diameter 40 mm se bhi upar hua to?
what I am unable to get the your voice.
सर कभी रोब डायमीटर 40 mm से भी अबव रहा तो यहाँ 39 तक का ही रेंज दिया है।
See, mostly your rope diameter won't exceed the limit given in PSG. If at all it exceed, then you have to take the maximum value which is available in PSG. In most of the cases, it won't go beyond that. Right.
ओके
So
सर,
if you can see, I have selected sheaf for diameter 34.5. Based on that, from PSG 9.10, you please tell me the value of A, B, C, E, H, and L. Then we'll move forward. Please refer your PSG and tell me the values of A, B, C, E, H, L. A is
90,
90 mm. All
B
dimensions are in
70,
mm. B is 70.
C15,
C, it is 15.
E is 2.0,
It is 2.
H is 55,
55
L is
and the
22,
L
22.
22 mm. So these are the proportions of your sheaf. You can see where A, B, C, E, H, and L are there in your sheaf, right? And also some diameters are given to you. So now see what we will do for the diameters. For diameters, we have one proportion, D min by D is equal to 23. स्टेप नंबर वन में ये था हमारे पास, डी मीन बाय डी इज इक्वल टू 23, मतलब ये प्रोपोर्शन है हमारे पास. व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ डी मीन? एक्चुअली इट इज द मिनिमम डायमीटर ऑफ पुली, मिनिमम डायमीटर ऑफ द पुली, राइट? सो जस्ट मल्टीप्लाई दिस डी एज 29, यू विल गेट द मिनिमम diameter for the pulley. Also,
Seven.
based on the diagram above, what we can conclude is maximum diameter of the outer diameter of the pulley is minimum diameter plus 2 times H. You can check with the diagram. Minimum diameter is diameter below the rope. जैसा डायमेंशन आपका बना हुआ है ना, सो हियर योर रोप इज फ्रॉम द सेंटर, दिस इज द वैल्यू एच. सो इफ यू वांट द मैक्सिमम डायमीटर, इट विल बी डी मिनिमम प्लस 2 टाइम्स एच. सॉरी, दिस इज डी मिनिमम एंड दिस इज योर एच फ्रॉम हियर. फ्रॉम हियर टू हियर, दिस इज कंप्लीट डी, दिस इज आर, दिस इज आर, सो इट बिकम्स डी. एंड फॉर द मैक्सिमम
ट्रिपल सेवन
डायमीटर you have to add this, so this becomes 777 mm. Also, a small angle, if you can see, a small angle is available there that you need to find, that is known as fleet angle. The angle is given by tan inverse check whether you are getting some answer for this angle. Is known as fleet angle.
तो पीएचडी में इसका फॉर्मूला नहीं है।
Need to check with the PSG ones. No, the formula of alpha is not available here.
सर वो कौन सा एंगल है जो अपन फाइंड कर रहे हैं?
One second. See the angle between B and the rope. ये जो ऊपर वाला एंगल है ना, the one which is turning over here. See, because here it is straight and it is going straight here. You have to find this fillet angle. At what angle you have to fillet? Actually, all the fillet will have the same angle. Fillet दिख रहे हैं ना आपको डायग्राम में? In the diagram, you can see there is fillet. All the fillet will be having this angle. Wherever there is a radius present, there you have to fillet with some angle. This angle will be used for filleting that. What is the answer of that fillet you are getting?
3.02.
Yes. Correct. Are you getting the point from where you, we will use this angle?
सर वही ना जो नीचे यहाँ पे मतलब रोप और शेप का कांटेक्ट हो रहा है पुली का, रोप और पुली का, वहां से जो फिर एक रेडियस देके जो बाहर निकला है, एंगल जो आ रहा है।
सी एवरीवेयर देर आर एजेस, वी नीड टू फिलेट इट एवरीवेयर इन All the point of contact, there are certain radiuses provided, R1, R2, R3, R4. To make that radius possible, you have to fillet it. Getting the point?
सर अल्फा की वैल्यू मेरा 8.13 आ रहा है।
No. Please check. 3.02 is correct, as I have also found that only. Right, can we move on? Are you getting the value? Yes.
Yes.
Okay, so moving on to the next step, that is step number three. See, we have selected one sheave and pulley. We don't need to do any type of calculation for the sheave and the pulley. Actually, the point is, if PSG is giving a standard sheave and pulley, we don't need to check for that again and again. So we will just select that sheave and pulley and we will proceed further. Right, so we have selected one pulley. Now, the pulley is there, the rope is there. Now what we need to move on is, we have to basically move on for the mounting of the pulley, where the pulley will be mounted. But before going on to the mounting of the pulley, we will design the bearings which will be used for rotation of the pulley. Right, so let us go for selection of bearing. Before selecting the shaft, we will go for selection of bearing, and based on this bearing diameter, we will try to select the diameter of shaft. ठीक है, या वी कैन डू वाइस वर्सा, वी कैन फर्स्ट सेलेक्ट द एक्सियल एंड देन बेस्ड ऑन द एक्सियल वी विल सेलेक्ट द बियरिंग, दैट कैन ऑल्सो बी डन, राइट? Anyways, you can do, you can select the shaft first, and based on the shaft, you can select the bearings. For now, we will select the bearing first, and then based on the diameter of that bearing, we will check whether our that we have selected is proper or not. So I have told you, given you a standard procedure of selecting a bearing. See, we require now two bearings as we have two pulleys, but we will design one and the other one will be same what we will design. So the first sub step in your selection is the load required. So we can have one radial load that is FR. So if you can see in the step number one, we have one load available to us that we can take it as a radial load. The radial load, if you can go and check in your step one, there is one load available that is F4P, that is 2770 kgf. That will be the load. Right? Then what you need is speed. We want speed of the pulley. Why you want speed? We want speed to convert, yes, life into million revolution. See, we want have formula of revolution, life in revolution, LH into N into 60 upon 10 raised to 6, where N is the speed. Now, mostly in the question, speed is given, but now in this question, speed is not given, so we have to calculate that speed. We have velocity given to us. Velocity of hoisting, how much is the velocity of hoisting given to us?
0.1 meter per second.
Yes, 0.1 meter per second it is.
Yes.
0.1 meter per second. This is the hoisting velocity. Based on this velocity, we can find the speed. Right? What is the formula for speed? Pi d n upon 60. So 0.1 pi. So you have to take here mean diameter into n upon 60. So first calculate mean diameter. Find in meters so that you can easily find your speed in RPM. Calculate d mean in meters, since we have velocity in meter per second. That is your mean diameter. Okay, so you got the mean diameter. Now you tell me, how much will be the speed?
2.65
RPM. Okay, so now we have the force and the speed with us. Now what we'll do is we'll proceed for the life. Once we have the life, we can calculate the dynamic load carrying capacity, right? We can calculate dynamic load carrying capacity. So as I have told you, if life is not given to you, assume the life of the bearing for 3 or 4 years, right? So let us assume life for 4 years and working for 8 hours per day. Working for 8 hours per day. Right? Number of days. Again, we have to assume number of days. So take that as 300 days in a year. Right? So now L life in hours will be 300 days into 4 years into 8 hours per day. So this become your L hours, life in hours. So please calculate and tell me how much you are getting.
9600.
9600 hours. 9600 hours it will be working. So now convert that hours into revolution. Into revolution. The formula is written. Based on that, you calculate life in revolution.
One point five three.
It is 1.53 million revolution MR. So now we have load and life. Once we have equivalent load and life, we can go for dynamic load carrying capacity. So in the next step, we need to calculate equivalent load. As I said you, as we are avoiding one of the load of the bearing, what you can do is directly multiply your radial load with a factor of 1.5 and calculate equivalent load. This is just for a shortcut we are using, since we have neglected that X, Y, S, KT, all we have neglected. In one sense, we are not neglecting it. We are combining it and taking one factor as 1.5. Right, so we are not neglecting it, we are considering, but directly as a 1.5 factor. Multiply that with your radial load, you will be having your equivalent load. Once your equivalent load is there, we will go for dynamic load carrying capacity. Calculate that and let me know.
4155.
It is in KGF. Right, this is nothing but your capital C. So if you see the formula on 4.2, if you see the formula on TAG 4.2, C is equal to L raised to 1 by K into PE, and as we are selecting ball bearing, as we are selecting ball bearing, K is equal to 3. So our life, if you can see, it is 1.53 million revolution raised to 1 by 3 into equivalent load is 4155. So you multiply this, you will be getting your dynamic load carrying capacity. बेस्ड ऑन दिस कैपेसिटी वी सेलेक्ट द बेयरिंग.
कैमरा ऑफ हो गया.
ओके
4787.79.
वंस मोर प्लीज.
4787.79.
1.523 है सर, जो एल का वैल्यू है.
ओके नो no problem. You can get your value of different value of C, whatever you are getting. Based on that, you select few bearings and keep it. Then we will select the diameter on shaft, and the, based on that diameter of shaft, we will select the bearing there. So you select different bearing which will be having this capacity. From different pages, 4.12, 4.13, 4.14. So for from 4.12, what is which one, which bearing you are selecting?
SKF 6021.
How much is the diameter of that bearing?
105.
It is 105. Mm. And how much is the capacity?
5700.
Okay. Then from 4.13, the next series.
Six two one five.
And diameter will be 60.
75.
5200. See the next one.
Six three one zero 4800 capacity.
ठीक
सर. कैमरा.
यस. Right. So these are the different bearings which we can select. If you can select few more, if 64 series is also available, if you want, you can take it from there. Else, what we can do now is we can proceed for selection of shaft, and then based on that selection, we will select one bearing. Right. So don't select anything now. We have selected these three bearings for now. After the selection of shaft, any one we will pick, and there we will select. Okay. Do anyone have any doubt in this?
Sir, DGBB से अलग भी bearing ले सकते हैं ना, taper, roller.
Any bearing you can select. DGBB give us more flexibility of selecting the bearing because there are more series available in DGBB. And since this is a pure radial load, DGBB is easily available also. Okay, any bearing you can select, no problem with that. Can we move on? Okay. So the next step, that is step number four. Next step, that is step number four. Here we will select the shaft, but the name of the shaft for this is design of axle. Axle means stepped shaft. Stepped shaft. Right? So, in the PPT which I have shared with you or shown you that day, see, there are two pulleys we are mounting here on the shaft. The distances we have to assume or take from the selection of the pulley, right? Now, just make the line diagram. I will tell you how you will get the various distances. These are the reactions. These are the weight of the pulley. So, this will be two times the tension in the pulley. This will be again two times tension in the pulley. Just draw the diagram. I will tell you how this will come into picture. Yes, are you done with the diagram, line diagram?
Yes, sir.
See, this is your shaft drawn by a line. These are the two ends which will be holded by the shackle plate or the side plate, right? So if there is something in contact with the plate, there will be reactions. So these are your reactions. Reactions as they are mounted on both the sides. And then these are the two pulleys which are being mounted on the shaft. Since in the question we have two pulleys, therefore we have drawn two forces over here. If it would have been one pulley, we would have drawn over here. If it had been three pulleys, we would have drawn three pulleys over here. But mostly there are two pulleys. Mostly, if there are two, three, four, five more pulleys, then you have to increase the length of the shaft. See, what is L1 now? How L1 will come into picture? L1 is nothing but the value of A plus margin. From where A comes into picture, see, the pulley will be mounted here. So the maximum outer width of the pulley is A. If you can see in your first step which we have done today. See this step, the maximum width is A. Right, that is 90 mm. So here it will be A, here it will be A, and in between you have to leave some space, right? A over here, A over here, that means a by 2 plus some margin. Therefore A plus margin I have written. Getting the point, A on this side, this is A plus A on this side, but our L is coming in between over here because the force is acting from the center and this is L1, therefore a plus some margin, then L2 will be coming over here. This is L2. Similarly on the other side it will be L2 over here, right? So this will be A plus margin. So margin can be in the range of 25 to 50 mm. Right, so let us take it as 30. So your A will be 120 mm. Sorry, L1 will be 120 mm. Getting the point? Similarly, L2, if you can see here, half the portion of A plus again the margin. Some margin over here, some margin over here. See, this margin is half this margin. So that way you can add. So this is 45, or again you can take that same range of margin, 25 to 30. So again take 30. Do you have any doubt in this? Do you have any doubt in this?
इसको एक बार फिर से explain करो.
See, this is your maximum width of the pulley, which is mounted over here, right? And the force will be acting from the center. Again, this is your maximum width of the pulley. The force will be acting from the center. दोनों के बीच का distance निकालना है. So this will be a by 2 plus margin. So a by 2 plus a by 2 becomes a, and the margin you can take from 25 to 50 mm. Right? On the opposite side, if you see, this is a by 2 plus the margin, that becomes L2. So a by 2 plus margin I have written. This is L2 again, this is L2. They are same. A by 2 plus margin. Okay, so the margin is between two pulleys. We should have some space between two pulleys. There should be some space so that they do not come in contact with each other, else while the time of rotation they will collide with each other and the system will break. So you have to keep some margin between the two pulleys while they are in rotation.
Sir, agar three pulley rahi to?
So you mount three pulleys. Yahan par L1 hai, yahan par ek aur L1 aayega. You have to increase the length of the shaft. L1 will be repeated again over here, then L2 will come. Getting the point? Similarly, if you have four pulley, there will be three L1. See, ये अगर आपका शाफ्ट है, तीन पुली है, तो एक पुली का फोर्स यहां पर, एक पुली का फोर्स यहां पर, एक पुली का फोर्स यहां पर, दो रिएक्शन होंगे यहां पर. These distances are fixed. This will be L2. This distance is fixed. This will be L2. This will be L1. This will be L1. And similarly, if the pulleys are increasing, L1 will keep on increasing.
Sir, agar khali single rahegi to pulley.
See, if there is a single pulley over here, then L2, L2. Single pulley. L2, L2.
फिर जो जो सिंगल पुली का जो अरेंजमेंट है उसके अंदर हम मार्जिन नहीं करेंगे ना, कंसीडर
कंसीडर करेंगे ना, क्यों नहीं करेंगे? L2 क्या है? A by 2 plus margin. फॉर्मूला थोड़ी चेंज होगा. L1, L2 का फॉर्मूला फिक्स है. डिस्टेंसेस okay. खाली चेंज होंगे आपके. अगर आप यहां से मार्जिन नहीं लोगे, then this side of the pulley will come in contact with your plate, side plate, and then they will stop working. They will collide with each other if you don't keep any margin between plates. See, the formula of L1 and L2 will remain same based on the arrangement. Any arrangement will be done. One pulley, two pulley, three pulley, four pulley, any number of pulley, the formula of L1 and L2 will not change. Okay, can we move on?
Yes.
So these are your arrangement. Now this is your force and this is your force, right? This force we have already calculated. That is that force only that we have used for selection of the bearing. That is 2770 kgf, a single force, tension if you can say. Right, and same if this is 2t, this is 2t, the reactions will be 2t and 2t. See, there are two forces, two reactions. This will be equal, this will be equal. If it is single 2t over here, then this reaction will be t and this reaction will be t. If this is 3, then you have to take summation Fy is equal to 0, summation of moment is equal to 0, and find the reactions. Right. Now moving ahead, what you need to do is you need to calculate the bending moment, and based on the bending moment you have to select the diameter. But before proceeding, you have to select the material for the shaft or axle. Bina material ke agar aap bending moment ka formula use karoge, then it will be difficult to find that forces or the stress, right? So you have to select one material. Let us select C35 as the material for the axle, right? If you go to PAG 1.9, you can see the properties of C35. That is ultimate tensile strength is equal to 310 MPa. Take factor of safety as 3, right? So you'll get tensile strength, shear strength. This is 104 MPa. Take it half, that is 52 MPa, based on the principal maximum stress theory, right? C35 material from PAG 1.9 we are taking. So this is the yield, that is the stress of the material given in PAG. Then you consider factor of safety, based on that find tensile strength and shear strength, right? Here you can assume bending equal to tensile. There you can assume that this is equal to your bending stress. It is actually 1.1 times or 1.2 times, or you can take it as equal to 1, right? This we got. Now what we will do is we will compare by using the bending moment equation, right? We'll find bending moment first, and based on the bending moment stress we will calculate. So bending moment, if you can see in the diagram, you have to take moment at any one point, either on this point or on this point, right? So we'll take bending moment over here. See, I won't go into the detail of how to take the bending moment. I will directly write one formula. See, at any point, if you are taking, you have to consider this part only. If you are taking at this point, there are many rules which you can see in your SOM textbook, how to take the bending moment. Now, if you can tell me what will be the formula of bending moment, as far as I think, it will be 2T into L2. Right, so we have T. T you convert into Newton. The T which I have written is 2770 kgf. In Newton you write it over here, and in mm you write the value. How much it will be in Newton?
2770.
बोलिए न्यूटन में कितना होगा?
210 हो जाएगा ना, 2770
मतलब
2770 था ना, तो न्यूटन के लिए बस 10 से मल्टीप्लाई कर देंगे.
आर यू श्योर? ठीक, चल बेंडिंग मोमेंट निकालो कितना आ रहा है. Then based on the bending stress formula or the flexure formula we will solve. Tell me how much you are getting the bending moment.
Four point one five into ten raised to six
newton mm.
4.15.
4.15. Right. So now we can use this flexure formula or the shear stress, bending stress, and get this value. What we can do is, we can put the value of stress which we have taken from the material and get the value of diameter, right? So what is the value of stress we have? That is 104. So put it here, get the value of diameter. Tell me how much diameter you are getting. From material property. This you have as 104 MPa Newton per mm square. Could that get the diameter?
74 mm.
That means 75 mm. Yeah, all are getting the same.
74.07.
Yes, okay. So this is the diameter of your shaft. Based on this diameter, you can select the bearing now. But before going there, check for shear stress. Check for shear stress. Shear stress is equal to force upon area, that is 2A, 2T upon A. We need to check here. 2 into 2700 upon pi by 4. Into 75 square. How much stress you are getting? This stress should be less than the one we have. Check it.
Twelve point five three
MPa. Since this is less than the one we have, therefore design is safe for the shaft, and after this selecting SKF six two one five as the bearing with D equal to 75. So shaft is also selected and the bearing is also selected.